Hey everybody, it's Invictus! Time for another Gul'dan game here on the channel. Today, we're going to be playing on the Cursed Hollow, and our team today is going to be Gul'dan, Dehaka, Sonya, Zagara, and Nova, taking on Chromie, Tracer, Sylvanas, Crazy Uncle Chen, and Diablo Duncan Stan. So what I'm going to be doing today, this is going to be actually my very first game that I've played against real people on Gul'dan. Now, one thing I will say is that I haven't really been playing a whole lot of Gul'dan lately, and it's not necessarily because I don't like Gul'dan. I think that Gul'dan's actually fairly strong, on the contrary. It's just that right now, there is still a lot of excitement around Gul'dan, and at the time of this recording, the queue times are still long. But I know that everyone does not want to see another bot game, and I wasn't even going to entertain the thought of doing another bot game. By the way, level 1, I did go for Glyph of Drain Life. I've been looking at this build, and honestly, been trying to play this build against bots. It's been working fairly well, but I mean, you can't really take that with too much salt there. You can only say, like, oh yeah, you know, congrats, you were beating bots, Invicta. It's like, yeah, no, but one thing I will say is that, and I've already kind of talked about this before, with not only Heroes of Storm in general, but also just, like, just basically, I guess the thought of doing other builds against bots is not necessarily a bad thing. It's just that you have to make sure that you don't, like, ruin other people's, like, enjoyment of the game. And I know that's kind of like that's a little bit of a herp-derpish thing to say, because, like, well, you know, you can't really affect the way that people feel about a game and that sort of thing. But you don't want to screw up someone's game, even in Quick Match, really, because you're trying to do a new build. So that's the reason why I kind of play against bots. Again, I have no problem. I have absolutely no problem with saying that, yeah, you know what, I'm just going to try a new, build, just see how it goes. And this build's, I've been playing enough comfortably to where I can be like, yeah, you know what, I think that it might work out. So this is what I'm going to be doing today. Is going to be a Drain Life build, and I like it a lot. It does have a couple of downsides, of course, mainly the fact that you're not really going to be dealing a whole lot of burst damage. I mean, you can still use Fel Flame, but for the most part, this is going to heavily emphasize trying to make sure that we're nailing the kills with Drain Life, which is going to reduce the cooldown of Drain Life by 6 seconds. And we're going to see that level 4 come up here for the health funnel, and that is going to reduce the cooldown of Drain Life. I don't know why there's no one up here in the top lane, but I guess we'll just go ahead and take it here. So another thing I want to kind of talk about really fast, and this is totally my fault on this as well. I wasn't really transparent enough when it came to discussing why we don't see Solo Queue Silliness on the channel anymore. And I talked about it at great length on my social media. I've talked about it on the stream, but I also realize that not everyone uses social media, so, you know, it's understandable for those of you who might feel a little bit out of the loop. And I'm going to take that time really quickly to discuss this now. So basically, Solo Queue Silliness is, right now anyway, in this current iteration of the series, it is going to be relegated to just showing off new heroes and basically trying out new builds, that sort of thing. Nothing too crazy, nothing too fancy, that sort of thing. But as far as, like, an actual, like, regular series goes, I'm not really in a hurry to do more Solo Queue Silliness. And the reason why I feel that way is because I'm not enjoying the game when it comes to Solo Queue. Now, I know that that's going to seem a little counterintuitive. It's like, well, you know, you're being silly because, you know, that's the whole nature of the game, name of the game, Solo Queue Silliness, etc. And it's like, yeah, I kind of get that, but as some of my longer time fans will know and will note, I don't really do stuff that's not fun for me. Towards the later parts of the last couple of games, Solo Queue Silliness, I think that it was probably apparent that I wasn't too happy with how things are going. I don't really care about losing. I posted many losing games on the channel before, and I will most likely continue to do so. But the problem with Solo Queue Silliness is that there would be times where I would try to get out a couple games going. Like if I try to make time to get like two or three games recorded, that I would simply just not have a usable game. And again, I know that it's going to be easy to kind of say, like, whoa, this Invicta just doesn't want to post losing games. No, you can check the backlog. I posted many losing games. I do not have a problem posting losing games. I lose frequently in many games that I play, not just Heroes of the Storm. But they have to be entertaining. And after a certain point, it was like, I don't really want to make time for the series anymore because it feels like a waste of time because of the fact that, like, I would queue up, and then, like, either the teams would be bad or I didn't particularly feel like I played that well, and then after that, it's like I just don't have a usable video here. Like, you know, my job is kind of twofold here. I do want to make sure that I'm making entertaining content, but I also want to make sure that I'm, you know, covering games that I'm enjoying. And right now, I truly mean it when I say I'm enjoying Heroes of Storm casting way more so than playing it right now. Now, that's not to say that Invicta all of a sudden hates Heroes of the Storm, or, you know, he's dogging on the game or dogging on Blizzard, nothing like that. It's nothing like that. It's just right now I'm prioritizing my time to be a little bit better spent doing, and on top of everything else, playing games that I want to play, playing games that I'm having fun enjoying playing with. And right now just playing regular solo queue ceilings is not really all that enjoyable for me. So that's pretty much the short and skinny of the situation. I apologize for not being as transparent as I should have been on YouTube. That's something I should have talked about a while ago. And it was incorrect for me to just assume, like, oh yeah, like, you know, well, obviously everyone's going to kind of notice that there's no solo queue ceilings. Obviously they should know why there's no solo queue ceilings. That was an incorrect thing to do. So why is Zagara standing on the mount? Yeah, never mind. Either way, we are able to get one tribute back here. We're also doing a pretty good job at soaking up the lane. Nice hit there by Nova. Might get the kill on Tracer. I gotta be careful of Chromie, however. You see how important it is for Gul'dan to get those drain lives off as often as possible, especially with Chromie trying to tee off on me. Level 10 here, I am going to be going for Horrify. Horrify is going to be a little bit different from the Reign of Destruction. I liked Reign of Destruction, I think it's okay, but honestly, I don't think there's any comparison to Horrify. Horrify is just what she picked. Zagara got like 65-0 by one Dragon Breath. That's pretty amazing from Chromie here. So 6.5 minutes, it's 9-6. And again, we've been doing a pretty good job at soaking up the lane. I haven't really been doing too much brawling, that's okay. I definitely want to just kind of get my mana up here. And talking about Gul'dan real quick, one thing that is a little bit annoying for me for Gul'dan is, why can't we just have, like, I don't understand why I can't, like, mount and still be able to life tap. I was able to get the fear off on Sylvanas, by the way. Diablo and Crazy Uncle Chan are going after Dehaka here. You see me teeing off there with Felflame. Down goes Diablo. We did lose Dehaka. I had the drain life going on Uncle Chan. Nice Ancient Spear there by Sonya. I do have to be very, very cautious of Chromie. Nova does a nice job getting the hit on Chen there. You did see that Chromie was over here somewhere. There she is. I think that Zagara is going to be fine. You did see Zagara did go for the newly improved and awesomer Nidus Worm. Looks like Chromie was taken out by Nova as well, so nice job all around. But yeah, that's the last thing I will say about Solo Queue Ceilings is it will most likely be back in the format that you all have come to know and love. And I do appreciate the support on Solo Queue Ceilings throughout the years because it's been easily the most popular series on my channel by far. I mean, it's not even close. But I do have somewhat of a... I do have somewhat of a guideline that I need to enjoy the games that I play, and I think that everyone pretty much knows that if Sinvicta's not enjoying itself, it does kind of translate fairly often and fairly well in a game when I'm not having fun, and I don't want solo queue ceilings to turn into a negative thing. So yeah, I'm sure it will be back one day in the way that we used to, but right now it's just going to be used just to show off new heroes, try out new builds, that sort of thing, sort of on a casual level. But as far as Almost Heroes goes, Almost Heroes have been doing very, very well, and I appreciate everyone's support on that. I know that Almost Heroes is not exactly as exciting sometimes for some people as Solo Queue Ceilings, but I do appreciate the support nonetheless. I'm going to go ahead and activate Horrify here. Unfortunately, Chen ended up running the wrong way from me, and that's okay. We only need one more tribute to go. So, by the way, what I was talking about with the life tap here, not drain life. If I said drain life, I meant life tap. Whenever you use life tap, it does dismount Gul'dan, which is a little bit annoying. I would like to be able to kind of life tap en route. So down goes Chromie, and we should be able to get, yeah, down goes Tracer as well. I was able to get, you saw there with the increased or decreased cooldown here, I was able to get the life drain on Tracer before she died. Well, maybe not. I guess the Chen and Sylvanas wanted to actually go here, which is surprising to me considering that they're down by three members of their team. Make sure I don't get hit by Apocalypse here. And I'm going to try to protect the Haka as well. Down goes one Crazy Uncle Chen. I'm going to life tap again because I'm out of mana. There we go. And I guess we might as well just take this Night Camp too while we're here. Got to be careful of Tracer. Definitely need to be super careful of Chromie. There we go. Drain life. And down goes Crazy Uncle Chen. Here comes Chromie. I'm going to see if I can peel here for Sonya. No, Sonya. That's a terrible place to try to go back. She's lucky that Chromie wasn't paying attention because that was going to be one dead barbarian. I do have a Horrify up ready to go, and I will use that on Chromie. So Zagara is just going to push down yet another fort here. I do not want to get hit by the wombo combo of Chromie's Dragon Breath along with Sandblast. I'm going to get a lot of damage on Tracer. Look at that. There we go. I'm going to grab this Watchtower too, just so we can maintain a little bit of vision here. I'm a little bit sad that we're not going for a boss camp right now. We are up by 3 levels. But of course, we all know that that can turn on a whim here. And we certainly don't want to make any sort of plays that would give our enemies a chance to get back into this game.
Enough. The curse is over.
So Zagara and I, that's that mount. Zagara and I are gonna take out the Night Camp here. It's a little bit weird that we didn't actually get a even try to go for the boss camp. It looks like the Haka wants to do it now, which I guess we still could do. We just have to be very, very careful here. I'm gonna come back this way. Level 16. I'm going to be going for the Rampant Hellfire here. I'm making sure that I was trying to see if Chromie was actually coming up on this side, and I just looked at the minimap and realized she was not there. Fair enough. Anyway, Rampant Hellfire is going to increase the amount of Fel Flame damage by 6%, and that does stack up to 30%, I believe, anyway. 6%, yeah, it stacks up to 5 times. So 30% total. Basically, just hitting him, you'll get to see this little meter down here, and that will show you exactly how much ability power you're going to be gaining from hitting those Fel Flame. Yeah, they're definitely going for the boss, which is a terrible idea. No, they're not going for the boss. Where are they actually right now? Yeah, there's Uncle Chen. I see Tracer, Chromie, and Sylvanas up in the top lane. I'm not going to use Horrify here, but I definitely want to make sure that we get this boss camp. And it looks like we're going to be able to take it. Ah, that was me not paying attention. I was looking at my health, trying to figure out when I was going to life tap. Definitely going to use life tap here. As you see there, you can still life drain on boss mobs, and that's a very good trade for us. We end up getting both the boss camps anyway, which is very nice. I'm just going to go ahead and life tap myself here. There we go. But I am enjoying Gul'dan a lot. I think that he has a lot of potential to be a scary, scary assassin. A couple of the downsides that I've noticed with Gul'dan is definitely the lack of escape. But obviously, when you're talking about an assassin that strong, you definitely don't want to give them too much leeway as far as getting in and out of sticky situations. If you look at Chromie, even Chromie doesn't really have a great way to get out other than hopefully landing, you know, a very desperate time trap. So, you know, it's for everything about... Oh, man, that was a... That was a nice corruption by me, I will say, and then a nice little follow-up there by Nova. And look at that, we were able to save Sonya there right at the end, even taking the Siege Giant camp here as well. So we are absolutely firing on all cylinders right now. It's 21-7. And again, I really don't feel like I've been doing all that much fighting right now. Look at the map with all the creep. The new Zagara is so scary. And I think I can destroy the time trap with corruption and Fel Flame here. There we go. I know that Chromie is going to be shooting for me. Now, if my feet were held to the fire and people wanted to know, Simvicta, who do you like more? Who would you like to rather play right now? Chromie versus Gul'dan, I would easily say Chromie. I love playing Chromie. I love her playstyle. I love everything about Chromie because of the fact that she is so sort of unassuming. And she gets underestimated a lot, and I think it's because she does have a gnome model. I'm just being honest. Like, a lot of people really still seem to, like, they don't understand that Chromie can absolutely destroy your entire team in literally 2 moves. I almost got the kill there on Chen. I actually didn't really mean to use Horrify there. I was hoping that Nova was going to drop the Orbital Strike. Unfortunately, I don't think she had it up yet. Or she just used it. I wasn't really paying attention there. I land the corruption. Look at the that dot damage on Tracer. So massive. Tracer's going to sit here and try to... She's going to be content trying to fight with a Nova around here. That is... That's definitely pretty bold. I'm going to go up top here and grab the second tribute. So after 14 and a half minutes, it's 23-8. We've been absolutely mollywopping the enemy team here. This is going to be the second tribute of this cycle. But I do like Gul'dan. I'm interested and curious to do a Felflame build, which I will probably... Or not Felflame, but Felflame. Almost called a Hellfire build. That would be interesting if there was a Hellfire build where Gul'dan just nukes himself down to basically nothing. But I am interested in checking out a Q ability build. There is that quest. I tried it in the first look video a couple days ago when Gul'dan first came out, and it seemed a lot of fun. It seemed very, very potent. I just got to get used to using Corruption more as well. I've been trying to get better about using Corruption more in this game as well, and I think I've been doing a decent job. Level 20 here, I'm going to be going for Haunt. Haunt's going to basically just add a little bit of a debuff. Anytime I use Horrify, it's going to basically make them vulnerable, which makes them take an additional 25% damage, I believe it's amplified, yeah. From all sources, which is very good. So got to be careful of Crazy Uncle Chen. I definitely need to watch out for Chromie. And I'm going to look to try to get a big Horrify out. There we go. I was able to fear Sonya, or not Sonya. I was able to fear Nova. Not Nova, Chromie. I'm trying to fight here and also do commentary while not getting killed from Tracer. I did finally get taken out, and I did not have Drain Life up. But we were able to turn there. I did get hit Heroes of the Storm eventually, but we ended up trading a 3-for-1. I was a little bit out of position because I was too far away from my team, but I also kind of derped out on the Horrify. I should have definitely probably used that, prioritized it on Tracer instead of just hitting Sylvanas. If I had used that on Tracer, I definitely would not have died. I'm going to be honest, I wasn't expecting her to do that much damage, but yeah. If I had actually used it on her, I definitely probably would not have died. So it looks like we're going to get a win. But yeah, Gul'dan's a lot of fun. Definitely try this build. I'll leave a link down below to the build. And again, I do appreciate the support, everyone. And apologies for not being as transparent about the lack of solo queue silliness. Hopefully you understand. And again, I do appreciate the support. I'm going to wrap it up there. Have a great start to your day. And of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.